Since the inception of the Ebola outbreak, people have grown increasingly concerned. Then Ebola emerged in the United States. Thomas Eric Duncan contracted the disease and passed away at Texas Health Presbyterian Hospital. But as of the last week, a healthcare worker taking care of Mr. Duncan has gotten better. And Ashuka Mukpo, the freelance cameraman who contracted the disease on assignment for NBC, is now Ebola-free. Hofstra University students react to the Ebola outbreak.
For a while, there was so much doubt that Ebola would ever even be a concern in the United States. So now that it's here, with those cases in Texas and now a possible one in Newark, I mean, it's scary. I'm nervous.
Those countries that are dealing with it are already dealing with poverty on top of it, that Ebola does not help. The fact that it's bringing here to the United States, I feel it's one of those diseases that is going to be difficult to, you know, figure out an actual cure for, but I also think people are, in a way, blowing it out of proportion.
We can handle these medical emergencies very well. We have the resources to handle an outbreak and make sure that it doesn't spread too far. And generally, we all tend to be pretty hygienic.
The Ebola virus can only be contracted through bodily fluids, but new CDC guidelines mandate healthcare workers to be covered from head to toe with no skin exposed. From Hofstra University in Hempstead, New York, I'm Neil A. Caruso.